Hello and welcome to the Zapusis Arena for the home opener for your Braintree Wamps as they take on Brookline here today. Mike Wasso for BCAM TV, and Braintree coming in off of a 4-1 road win over Norwood to begin the season, getting results from all three of the lines. And this is a different Braintree team than a year ago, who lost to Duxbury in the postseason, and expectations are a little bit higher this season. And the Wamps looking to get off on the right foot with a home victory here against Brookline. It's actually a combined team between Brookline and Newton South. So the Warriors will be facing the Wamps, and we'll have the opening puck drop here in the first period right after this. Welcome back to the Zapusis Arena. Start of the first period as Braintree wins the opening faceoff, and Yaxter moving into the offensive zone, taking the shot, but it goes just wide of the cage. Targif playing in goal here today for Brookline as it's dumped into the Braintree end. And that'll be an icing for the first whistle of the game. That was a slow developing play, and it was whistled at the last second. There was no washout for the icing. So the correct call on the ice, as now Birchill on the faceoff, Braintree winning it off the shot, and it's blocked in front. Yaxter had the opportunity. Birchill playing it back to the point, and the shot from the point is knocked down in front and breaking back the other way. As the Warriors now on the back check, it's knocked away as Branch is able to successfully take it away. Holland was there. But Braintree turning it over in their own end, but now able to break out. A 3-on-2, now a 3-on-3 developing, as it's knocked into the offensive zone, and Holland going to give chase. Santaboni playing the right defense, now coming off for a change. Back behind the goal, as taking a quick spill was Hawk, but battling hard for it, as it's taken away, and back the other way, the captain for Newton South and Brookline, taking it out as Sheehan was looking to move it out of the Wamp end. Just about a minute and a half into the first period, still no score. Braintree controlling the opening minute plus, as Haw now with an opportunity trying to go between the legs of the defense, and that move was shut down. Lee is open in front, but the pass doesn't connect. Able to keep it at the point is Zanaboni. Around the dasher. And at the point, it does get past for a moment Summers. But Braintree able to control in their own end. Looking to transition and catch Brookline in a change. That one squirts back into the Wamp end. And Braintree will complete the change. Braintree looking to work it up the boards. Right now having a little bit of trouble getting out of their own ends. Santaboni forward as Braintree trying to tap it out. They can't clear. And now an opportunity but a mishandle. Both players overskating in that scenario. And now it breaks free. And an opportunity. Daugherty sending it across to the opposite side of the ice from McGurdy. Gertie with the backhand out in front as it's kept in at the point. Braintree hoping for a shot, and the shot is blocked away. That's the second time now that a shot from the point has been blocked in front. First touch of the game for Ellie Foley, the freshman goalie. A victory in her first varsity match over Norwood, 4-1. Out in front, and an opportunity for Yaxter. It goes off the heel of a blade. Backhanded chance as Yaxter able to knock it away back to center. Shifted back in towards the attacking zone as Yaxter again giving chase. Holland to her right. Good contact from Birchill, able to keep it in and pinch at the blue line. Holland behind the goal looking for somebody out in front. Birchill is open. Pass doesn't connect as it's worked around the boards. And now it's broken out by the Warriors. Able to work past Burchill. Another one of the captains, Crowley, working one on three. It squirts out in front and a score as that one beats Foley to the blocker side. So that was one of the two captains getting the goal. That was number nine, Victoria Storr, getting the opening goal here at the Zapusis Arena, Braintree's home rink here in Randolph. But not the start Braintree had in mind after controlling the early play. Opportunity out in front as a rebound and a tripping penalty upcoming as the stick was down in the skates, and Braintree will get right back on the attack with a power play here with 10.5 to go in the opening period. So the power play unit out there for Braintree. They'll have a 5-on-4 power play for 1.5 minutes. Draw is won by Braintree, and a shot from the point, and that one just wide. That shot was taken from the outside by Stimson. Looking out in front, and it's stuck in the pads, as it's covered by a target. Head coach Meg Lloyd applauding her team's effort, as they've been able to sneak a goal here on the road to take the early lead, but Braintree has things in mind on their own power play. First power play of the game out in front, and that was an opportunity just off the stick. Burchill able to keep it in the attacking zone, trying to slide it down behind the goal. Now looking out in front. Lee is there. It makes its way through, but it gets over the stick. It was a rolling puck. Cleared all the way back down, and that'll kill off just about half of the penalty. Nice little pass as Yachter trying to work it free. Cleared back out again, all the way into the defensive end as Lee has to give chase with 9.5 to go in the opening period. And that one sent to nobody in particular for the Wamps as that one trickles in, and Foley able to direct it to the sideboards. Not much going on this power play for Braintree. Having trouble getting it out and onto the attack. Just 10 seconds left on the uneventful power play for Braintree. Back to even strength now as the player exits the box. Shot from the point and it whistles wide. Nice check along the boards as Zanaboni able to move the shoulder right in front of the Braintree bench. Sent back to the blue line and again getting past the last line of defense for Braintree, but Summers able to send it back and it's knocked back in by Braintree. Doherty getting it into the attacking zone. Braintree doing a good job with possession. Just that one chance, all it took. Summers moving quickly and sends that one from behind the red line, so it will not, or right in front of the red line, so it will not be an icing. Knocked back out as far as center. Good battle along the boards, as Branch is able to move it out just shy of center. At center ice, Braintree looking to work it free. It was in the skates of Haw. And she has it now, working 2-on-3 up the ice. The shot taken, and it's blocked out in front. Burchill trying to split through two. Gets the shot off, but it's wide. French has had plenty of shots, but none really registered in on goal. But that certainly bodes well for Branch's chances moving forward, as they're going to continue to get some good chances here in the game. They're going to have to start converting by hitting the goal. Burchill all the way back on her own end, working past two skaters. Has Holland to her right. Now looking for the pass. It's just shy of the blue line. Dumped along the boards. Now Branchy looking for a crash in front as the centering pass doesn't connect. And the loose puck is controlled by Branchy. Right around the side of the goal as the Warriors will move it out. 1-on-2. Good defensive work in the Branchy end as Connolly was able to knock it free. It's still loose out in front. Foley able to work it aside, but Branchy not able to clear. Now it's loose in the skates as Burchill looking to work it free. Going 1-on-2, able to kick it forward as it pops free for Holland. Holland looking in front. It's Burchill. Has the goalie down, sends it out in front. And the shot and the save as the opportunity was there for Yaxter, who continues to press on the offensive side of the puck. Sent behind the goal for Holland as Branchy changes out the last line of defense. Able to get a change. As this one squirts out in front, Yaxter again trying to settle it down, looking for the shot, and there was none coming. 5.5 to go in the opening period. Branchy still trailing by a goal, but they've been able to get some good opportunities in the attacking zone. The player wide open in front for Brookline, but they weren't able to find the open player. That was Egan, who was wide open in front. It's knocked free, and now a chance as Hawk going 2-on-1, able to backhand out in front, and a score! Beautiful tic-tac-toe goal as Doherty scores the first home goal of the season for Braintree as they tie the game at 1. So that one set up by the backhand of Haw, and Braintree ties the score at 1. 5 minutes to go in the opening period, and a tie game. Doherty, the goal scorer for Branchy, moving it back in. No surprise that Branchy was able to tie it up after the amount of attacking time they've had here in the first period. It almost always translates over. The team with the most attacking time usually scores the most goals. But right now, Branchy able to knot it, now carries some momentum here in the opening period. That goal that Branchy scored was actually off of a turnover. It was an aggressive stick that Branchy was able to knock it free, but it was a pretty bad turnover that resulted in a goal for the Wamps. And all the credit going to Haw, who was able to backhand it out in front. That was not an easy pass through the defender. 4 minutes to go in the first period. Branchy now with an opportunity to try and get their first lead of the game. So far, the Wamps have allowed a goal, and they're also 0-for-1 on the power play, but they have the game now tied at 1. Yaxter able to backhand it forward. Continues to be a force in this first period. She's played strong, gotten a couple good looks as she's knocked down. And now an opportunity for the shot. Scores! Yaxter right under the bar. Able to walk in uncontested, and there is the lead for Braintree, a team that is primed for a lot of goals this season. They've already scored now 6 in just over 3 periods, so dating back to the game against Norway, they scored 4, and they've already scored 2 so far here in the opening period, and the second score of the period for the Wamps. That was Caitlin Yaxter, the senior forward, with her second goal in as many games. Frankie skating it back out. Norton able to stay on sides as Branchy pinches it back forward. moved up the glass and all the way down. This should be icing. With 2:56 to go in the opening period, the draw will be down the other end. Off of the draw, Brentry wins another one. It's deflected out in front of the backhanded shot, and it doesn't make its way in on goal. That was a great chance out in front for Stimson. .15 to go in the opening period as Haw has that one in inner skates, able to work it forward just over the blue line as the Brookline player falls over the imaginary blue line. Behind Branch's own goal, working it in their own end as Connolly able to work it up the sideboards, and Branch now 2-on-2 with a 3-on-2 developing. It's Birchill on the left, and on the right it's Holland out in front, and the chance is saved by Targif as Branch goes to the backhand looking for another opportunity. Right now with the one goal lead, they're looking to double it and go up by two as we head to intermission. And a bad turnover as here comes Yaxter again. Braintree on sides. Nice little touch pass for Birchill. The shot. And it's redirected in front. Holland's shooting. And it's a save and a second. As it's still free. And it's waved off. I don't know if the referee lost sight or if it was covered. Tough to tell from this angle. But the whistle came with 57 seconds to go in the opening period. As Braintree will have another attacking zone faceoff. And they have done excellent on these draws to begin the game. Shea losing the draw as Frankfurt loses one of their few in this first period. Duffy able to knock that one away as it squirts free along the side wall and is blocked out in front by Lee. Final half minute. Chance now coming out, and the shot is saved as Foley was able to knock that one away. It's still popping free here in the final 15. Braintree looking to clear it out. Not able to get it fully as it's shot wide. One last opportunity here in the final few seconds as Braintree will look to clear, which they do, and that'll kill the remaining seconds of the first period, and Branch will head into the intermission with a 2-1 lead after a slow start. Not able to convert some of the chances early. Branch fell behind by a goal. That one came just a few minutes in by Stoya. And then Branch with two goals to respond. The first goal coming off of the stick of Doherty, off the backhanded pass, and then Yaxter walking in alone, able to give Branch their first lead of the game. And that's where we stand, 2-1. After a period of play here at the Tafusas Arena in Braintree's home opener. We'll be back for second period action right after this.
We must score!
Great athleticism by the Lady Wong. Looking for the pylon, and he's got it. Touchdown, Braintree.
Oh, off the glass for two. Shot from Stimson, and it's redirected in front. Welcome back to the Zapusis Arena. Second period action underway. Mike Wassel here for BCAM TV. And a goalie change as Yaxter coming in and scores! Second goal of the game for Yaxter. And rudely greets Francis, who had just come in to play goal for Brookline. And she was tested just 7 seconds in. And already Braintree with a goal in the second period and the second of the game for Yaxter. Yaxter right now leading the team in goals with 3. Had a goal in the opening game against Norwood, and now 2 so far here today. We'll see if she can get one more to complete the hat trick. That one knocked aside by Foley, as Braintree has now a 2-goal lead. 2-on-1 development. Braintree on the offensive attack. That one off the mark for the Wamps, as this one is sent in on goal, and it's covered by Francis. .14:25 to go here in the second period. And Braintree getting a goal so far and now winning the faceoff as it squirts back to the blue line and the shot is knocked wide. Pretty good collision as Lee giving chase. And it's sent back out as Braintree looking to knock it away. It's back into the Wamp end. Zanaboni controlling for a while. You hear Coach Burchill looking to move the puck, and that's a dangerous press across the ice. Big time collision as Summers goes down and had the stick in her midsection. As the player was knocked down, and a good collision as Stimson and an offsides will be the call. .13:34 to go in the second period, as the draw is won by the Warriors back into the Wamp end, now at center ice. Braintree has scored the last 3 goals after dropping behind 1-0. Pretty good showing here for Braintree's first home game. As that one was stuck aside by Foley. Chance now, and a glove stop. That one may have been going wide, but taking no chances was Foley. Might be able to control the draw, sending it around the boards. And now a 3-on-3 up the ice. Holland looking to work it through the referee's skates. Is in the way right now. Now able to work it free. Squirting to the side. The extra was the intended target of that pass. Skating hard down the wing is Burchill looking for the centering pass. The extra at the side of the goal. And that one held by Francis. Another offensive draw. This one will be taken by Burchill. 12:24 to go in the second. Braintree winning the draw. A shot from the point. Doesn't make its way through. Now it's loose out in front as Burchill going in to rake it out. Sent back to the far point as Lee sends it down the wall. Burchill out in front, and that hard shot was blocked in front as Braintree again continues to have shots blocked, but they continue to press the issue. Duffy working it up the sidewall. And that one knocked off the stick of Holland as it jars free onto the stick of Lee, accelerating down the left wing. Lee working through one, sending out in front. Beautiful pass, and the shot is saved. Rebound and a score as it was tapped home at the side of the goal. And I believe Lee will be credited with that one. Burchill was also there jarring away. And I believe it was Lee who got credit for the goal, as Braintree now with four unanswered to take the 4-1 lead. Braintree now hitting the four-goal mark for the second straight game, and they still have more than half of this one to go. This one has potential for a blowout all over it. Lee having it over center ice. Right now, Braintree looking to move it into the attacking zone, but it pops back free to center. Braintree was looking for the change, wasn't able to get it far. And Brookline takes the change. Now Braintree will change as well. The new forward pair out there for Braintree as it's sent down the rink. And this will be icing on Braintree with 10:27 to go in the second. Off the draw, it's controlled by Brookline and just wide, as there was a player at the back door of the post. Working it back out as far as center, and back on the ice comes Rangers' top line. Burchill skating it past one and now down the end wall. Loses control and is sent back as far as center. Connolly with a nice tape-to-tape pass as Yaxter moves out. Already with two goals and able to sidestep through the defender. Looking for the centering pass, and it's held by Francis with 9:36 to go in the second. Burchill awaiting the draw. With the extra to her left. Looking in that direction. As it's loose in the skates and Francis coming flying out. It's still loose out in front as the goalie is down and out. But now able to get back to her crease. And the Wamps not able to convert on that chance. Just one penalty so far in the game, and that was on Brookline. Braintree not able to convert on that power play chance. Usually at the high school level, we see multiple penalties per game. Braintree, a very physical team, which obviously results in a lot of penalties, but it shows that the other team has to be careful where they go, because they're going to have to pay the price when they go to those tough areas, as there's an icing here on Brookline. Another draw won by the Wamps. The shot from the point from Summers finds its way through. Not on goal as now Haw working along the end wall. Haw has her stick held up and a whistle. And the draw is going to come outside of the blue line. Come on, giving chase is Lee, as Braintree again pressing. 8.5 to go here in the period. As the Wamps work it back up the side wall. A dangerous pass is intercepted by the Wamps, and now moving 3-on-2. A chance for Haas, sending it in the backhand out in front. Shot taken, and just wide of the glove side. Simpson had a great look. Summers is open at the point. Beautiful pass out in front as Hall was open, and it's covered by Francis. Excellent zone time by Braintree, getting another quality look. And now the Wamps showing that they are the more superior team. And they are exerting their forces, especially in the attacking zone. Dangerous pass again, cross ice as Norton goes for a tumble. Opportunity for Brookline, but a good defensive play as Braintree knocking that one off the stick. That was Emerson on the defensive challenge. In on goal, and it's held by Foley. Braintree will take a draw in their own end. And they'll get their top line out there. Burchill at center. And on the wings, Holland and Yaxter. Defense pair of Lee along with Duffy. The five in the ice for Braintree. Nice pass along the wall, and Braintree breaking it out now 2-on-1. Burchill with the puck has Yaxter to her left. She'll shoot, and that one was saved. May have gotten a piece of the stick. A lot on that shot. Yaxter would have been a good option as well, but that was a quality look from Burchill, who took a great shot in on goal. Sent behind the goal. As Holland has that one go off of her stick. Kept in the attacking zone. 6.5 to go in the period. Bad clearing attempt as Braintree able to keep it in at the point. Out in front, the backhanded shot, and that one is stuck aside. Still loose out in front. Three saves, now a fourth. Still loose along the post. And no whistle, and now it is, as that one was held along the line. I don't believe there's going to be a goal on this situation. Maybe a penalty coming. And I think that's exactly what's going to be the call. I believe a defensive player for Brookline put a hand on the puck, so Braintree will get a penalty shot. Certainly don't see that at many levels, but at the high school level, that is a very rare call to see. That one was loose for a while, and the goalie was out. So Holland will have the opportunity on the penalty shot. The freshman forward looking for her first goal of the game. Moving in, waiting for the goalie to make the move, and the shot, and a save. So Holland made a few nice moves, but the goalie stayed strong on the line and didn't bite for the fake. A couple nice moves, but it looked like Holland was trying to elevate under the bar and didn't get enough on it. So the score stays 4-1 as the faceoff is won by Braintree, but it's quickly cleared out. And now we'll see if any momentum is carried over by Brookline after the save on the penalty shot. Backhanded forward, nice pass. Lee able to thread it forward for Haw. Simpson to her right, the shot. Oh, it just whistled wide. An excellent shot from Haw. Everyone's starting to find some rhythm for this Braintree team. We've seen it all the way around. And it starts with those forwards, but the defense has played very strong after allowing a goal just a few minutes in. Battle right in front of the Warrior bench as Braintree's able to clear it out to center. Knocked back forward by Summers, and Braintree will take a change. 5 minutes to go in the period. Nice touch pass, and now an opportunity for Burchill. Holland back on the ice, along with Yakstra. Big time collision, no call coming. Braintree breaking it back out, 2-on-1 developing. Holland with it. Nice little pass for Yakstra, stopping on a dime. Now we're taking the shot, and the shot goes wide. It may have been blocked. Two goals on the game for Yakstra. It's a nice pinch from Emerson, keeping it in the attacking zone. Another keep at the line. The opposite side this time for the Braintree Wamps. Back behind the goal as Holland looking for somebody out in front, and that one is held by Francis. So Francis, after allowing a quick goal here in the period, has been under storm in her own end. Braintree easily could have 5 or 6 goals here in the game, but she's made a couple big stops, including the penalty shot save. Breaking back the other way is Wojciechowski. And now it's back the other way. The Wamps, oh, a nice skating move through. And going for a tumble as the goalie coming out of her mark. That chance was quick to develop, and Norton crashing the boards. Always an aggressive player, and that had a chance to be her first goal of the season, as that's back the other way and another icing. .328 to go here in the period, and that one covered off by Francis as the draw came in her direction. Seen her now 4 or 5 times in the period come out dangerously on her belly. Certainly not the most technical way to cover it up, because if you were ever to lose sight of that puck and have it go off the side of your glove, it's an empty goal for the opposing team to shoot at, but in that situation, it worked. Braintree with it behind the goal. As Haw and Lee both in the same area. Lee now with it on the backhand, still loose, and trying to knock that one through the 5-hole, but the pads stay closed. Able to keep it in the attacking zone as it's now behind the Brookline goal. Along the end wall, Stimson giving chase, and it's loose in the skates as Haw also there. She'll be the first one to it. Looking back for the pass for Stimson. Stimson able to send it out in front. Summers takes the shot, and it's free out in front as it skated all the way back out and dumped in as Brookline again will have to go for a change. That's been what they've had to do pretty much this entire period, is have to take changes because Braintree's been able to tire them down. The pass now for Holland, and the shot, it ricochets over the crossbar. Nice little stick check as we'll have a penalty upcoming. This one will be on Braintree, and Yaxter will be guilty of the tripping penalty. And there could have also been a hook prior to that, but there was no call given. That was prior to the trip from Yaxter, where she was hooked from behind, but I guess not enough stiff work on that chance. So Braintree will go on the penalty kill for the first time here in the game, with 1:55 to go in the second period, and a minute and a half power play upcoming. Brookline, Newton South wants to come back. They're going to have to convert on this chance right now, down by 3 goals, as that one makes its way outside of the blue line, and it is offsides. That one all the way down the rink, and it's knocked away by Francis as Brechel comes in with the body. Losing a glove out there on the ice was a Brookline player. That was Stoya who lost a glove. Braintree now able to knock the player down at the blue line. Here in the final 60 seconds of the period. Frankie looking for the clear, and they'll get it high off the glass where it does make its way as far as center. Just 15 seconds to go on the power play. Virchow knocking that one down, and it was dangerously close as it changed direction. And Braintree clearing it out, and that'll just about do it for the power play for Brookline. An unsuccessful power play with now 25 seconds to go, and now Yaxter out of the box. Final 5 seconds as the puck at center ice. One last chance, and that'll do it here for the second period as the buzzer sounds. And Braintree adds to their lead after one. They now lead 4-1 through 2 periods of play here at the Tupoosis Arena, and well positioned for their second win in 2 tries. Braintree up by 3 goals after 2 periods. An excellent period there for the Wamps, and Yaxter getting her second as Braintree now well in control here in the game, as we'll take a break and bring back the third period after this. Welcome back to the Zapusis Arena. Third period underway. Mike Wassel here for B-Camp TV, and the Wamps leading by 3 goals as we head to the third, 4-1. Skated back forward, as the backhanded pass out in front, side of the goal, and a score. As getting that one for Braintree right along the wall. And that was Yaxter scoring her third of the game. The hat trick completed. That was tough to tell from this angle. It actually looked like the uniform number said 21, but it was just a little crease in the uniform. And then on the skate back, it was Yaxter, confirmed for the hat trick, as Braintree now leading 5-1. So a put-away goal just 40 seconds into the third period. And that's exactly what Braintree did in the second. They scored just 7 seconds in. Sent down the rink and another icing on Brookline. 14 minutes on the dot to go in the game. And Braintree just those 14 minutes away from their second win on the season. Draw is sent to the side wall. Summers went for the gamble, and Braintree was able to send it out as far as the blue line, and that was dangerous out in front as Hall went sliding forward. That one nearly hit her right in the face off of the mask. Braintree will change it up as that one is dumped deep. Good aggressive stick from Daugherty, able to knock it free. Norton also moving towards the puck as it's sent and blocked off of the shot from Daugherty. Emerson looking for the shot, and that one also knocked away. Moving up the wing, and an opportunity now for Brookline. The shot is wide. A chance there for Kiprick. Warriors having to clear the line, and right now the stick of Daugherty in the uniform of Brookline able to jar it free now, and Daugherty able to play it forward up the sidewall, and Braintree again will change. The top line coming back on the ice. And a bad turnover. Yaxter now a chance for her fourth. Sends it on the backhand and easily taps it home. And a dangerous play as the defender coming barreling in and taking out Yaxter along the way. And thankfully, both players are okay after that. So Yaxter able to gather her fourth now of the game. And Braintree running away with it 6-1. And another goalie change for Brookline. They've been alternating goalies, and neither of the goalies have been able to get the job done here in the game, although that really had nothing to do with the goalie. It was a clear break, but a tough gamble to take for the goalie coming out of her mark. And once Yaxter was able to make the initial move, she was wide open and had the empty net to shoot at and tapping it home on the backhand. So Daugherty, Lee, and Yaxter, the scorers here in the game. That one popping into the catching glove of Foley, who really hasn't been tested much here in the game. So the Wamps well primed for a good season, starting off strong with two wins, assuming this one holds, as it seems to be the case. Pass from Stimson, and this will be a penalty on Braintree, as that one is either going to be a hook or a trip, and that is the signal. A hooking penalty coming to Lee as the stick was in the midsection. Seven and a half to go in the game, and a power play for Brookline, their second of the game. They weren't able to score on their first. All the way down the rink, as Braintree able to kill off a good 15 seconds on that clearing. Back the other way, 2-on-3 for Brookline, as they send it in, and it's kicked out by Foley. sent out in front and just wide of the post as Braintree looking now to clear it away as Haw gets it out. And now it's onto the stick of Stimson. Stimson along the wall, able to ward off the defender, now looking for the backhanded centering pass. Haw has it right behind the goal. It was on the skirt of the goal for a second. Another shot from a distance as it's stuck aside by Foley. Brenchy sending it back all the way down the rink as that one gets by the last line of defense. 10:20 to go in the game. Just 20 seconds to go on the power play. So far, special teams haven't had much on the offensive side. Braintree looking to kill their second penalty of the game. Braintree not able to score on their first power play, so the final 3 seconds now have concluded. Braintree back to full strength, and both teams have been 0-4 on the power play. Braintree only has had one chance on the power play, and that was back in the first period. Six goals at even strength for Braintree. With 9:40 to go, they'll send it out of their own end, up the wall. Referee in the way. Now he able to jump over the puck, and Braintree getting it out. Womps looking for a line change, which they get. Nice pass forward, just off the mark for Yaxter. She got a piece, so no icing. Stopping on a dime, Yaxter sending it in front. Birchill's shot and a save, a second chance, and it pops free to the side wall. Bad pass as Birchill intercepts. One right out in front, and now it's covered as Braintree was attacking. Another good shift for that top line. Sent behind the goal as Lee gives chase. Looking out in front, and it's intercepted. Loose in the skates, and now it's jarred out to center. And Braintree back in possession. Stimson looking for the shot as it finds its way in on goal, and it's knocked to the side wall. So Targif back in goal for Brookline. Started the game and was pulled after a period, and has now been replaced in the third. Shot and a save, as that was taken from a distance from Stimson. Not a ton on it, but Braintree has got to a lot of those loose pucks, so never a bad time for a shot. Line change for Braintree, getting caught a little bit there. And offsides at the blue line. 7:23 to go, and Braintree has added to their three-goal lead after two. They've added two here in the period at 6-1. The Braintree season last year ended with a postseason berth where they had to travel to Duxbury Inn. That was a tough one for Braintree. They really were overmatched in that game, but this has been a great start to the season. And a big hit there by the Womps, and that's going to be a penalty as Norton will go to the box for the body contact. Probably be a roughing call. 6:56 to go here in the game. It's Braintree looking to kill their third penalty of the game. Shot, and that one trickling free. Foley got the initial stop, but wasn't able to hold it. But Braintree able to clear it out as far as center. Yaxter and Burchill, the forwards on the ice. Duffy and Lee, the defense. Burchill will sky that one out to center ice. Right in front of the Wamp bench, and the pass doesn't connect. And Braintree pounds it back down. But it only gets as far as center, the shot taken, and a good 5 feet wide. Braintree could use a line change as they send this one down the rink. Not a ton of skating necessary. Moved into the attacking zone, and the shot taken from a distance. And that one was stopped by Foley as Perino let it go. Burchill has been out there the entire penalty. Still with a little bit of juice left in the tank. Now back to backhand, scores! Right as the penalty had yet to expire, so it is a shorthanded goal going from backhand to forehand and putting it home for the seventh goal of the game, and Braintree now with the 7-1 lead. So just 2 seconds left on the power play as Braintree's now killed off all three of the man-down situations. Norton out of the box, and Braintree back to full strength. 5:15 to go in the game, and Braintree has been impressive from start to finish. Just that one little hiccup early in the game, otherwise Braintree would be sporting a shutout. Pretty good collision along the sidewall as that one pops over the goal. Nice blocker stop from Foley as it's sent to the sideboard. Chance along the sidewall, and it's knocked away as Braintree looking to clear. So nine freshmen here for Coach Burchill's team, and they are all producing, including the goalie Foley, who will be now 2-0 in her first two varsity matches, and obviously getting plenty of support from her offense. 4 goals against Norwood, 7 so far here in this one, so 11 goals combined, and Braintree right now clicking on offense. And they've only allowed 2 goals to this point through the first pretty much 2 games. Just 3.5 to go here in the third period of the second game. Another penalty coming on Braintree. That's going to be a hooking penalty. As heading to the box is Doherty. So that's been the call here today. We've seen a couple hooks on Braintree. And in that situation, you're trying to really jar your stick loose, but it was right underneath the armpit of Brookline. So coaching still going on for Coach Burchill. Not happy with that penalty as Burchill has Yaxter in front. Burchill to Yaxter, and she scores. Yet again, another goal for Yaxter, and Braintree putting a thrashing on the Warriors. That's 5 goals now in the game, and Braintree's second shorthanded goal. I don't know what the record is for goals in a game, but Yaxter has to be approaching the record. Plenty of good girls have records here for Braintree, but that is not one that I'm aware of. Number of goals in a game, certainly goals in a season. As that one scores from outside of, just inside the blue line, that one finding its way through the legs of Foley. That's certainly one you want back if you are Braintree. Obviously, with the score the way it is, it doesn't hurt you, but that is one that needs to be stopped. And Foley knows that. Goal scored by Foligno. Sending it out in front, and another goal as Braintree able to convert, and that was Annie Lee converting right in front. Everybody getting into the act, and Braintree scoring now their third time shorthanded. That another record that is pretty much tough to repeat. If you can score one shorthanded goal in a game, you're very happy as a coach, and three of them is unheard of. 20 seconds left in the man advantage. Final 2 minutes here in the game. Nine to two right now. Braintree still on the attack. At center ice, coming all the way back and knocking it away was McGuire. Nice move from Lee, able to squirt free. McGuire with it, sending on the backhand for Lee, and the shot just wide as that one hit the back wall. Pretty good opportunity for Braintree. And a giveaway in their own end. The shot, and that one is wide, right underneath of the glove of Foley. Final 60 seconds here in the game. A chance out in front, and that one is wide. A couple good chances late for Brookline. Nice backhanded pass from Yaxter in the direction of Burchill, who fires that one, and a blocker save. Loose in the skates is Holland, looking to jar it free. Along the end wall, it's Yaxter here in the final half minute. Kept in along the wall, and a nice pinch from Summers. Final 15 seconds now, and Braintree just looking to kill the clock. Holding it along the wall. Yaxter with it behind the goal. In the final five, as Brookline possesses, they'll send it out. And that'll do it here at the Zapusis Arena, as Braintree will win by the final score of 9-2. This one never really a contest from start to finish, as the Wamps run away with this one. And it's actually a pretty close game after a period. It was 2-1, but Braintree able to extend it to 4-1 after two, and just absolutely smash Brookline here in the third period to the tune of 5 goals, and 2 of those came shorthanded. So the star of today's game, obviously, it's going to be Katie Yaxter with 5 goals in the game. Foley getting her second win as a varsity goalie, and Braintree as a team scoring 9 goals here today, and they've now allowed just 3 goals through the first 2 games. So defensively, they've gotten the job done, but the offense really the story here of this game. So the Wamps now 2-0, and they'll face Framingham in their next contest. Also Needham up on the schedule, 2 road games to follow this. So Braintree now 2-0 on the season, a 9-2 win here today at home, their first home game of the season. For Christine Patterson, I'm Mike Wassel. We'll see you next time.